My name is Susanne Moser. I'm a social science research fellow at Stanford University's Woods Institute for the Environment, and I am the director of my own research and consulting company in Santa Cruz, California. The records of climate change, global change, are just accumulating, whether it's the amount of sea ice that's being lost in the Arctic, the hottest year ever, the number of species that are being lost, the magnitude of this storm or that storm. We have so many lines of evidence already. We're actually now in a place of having unequivocal evidence that climate change is happening, and we are extremely certain that we're the major cause behind it. These systems are global in scope. They have very large driving forces changing them. Think of it like the Titanic. You know, you don't turn that big tanker in a very quick moment. You have to actually think long before you hit the iceberg. We have no more time to lose. In fact, we've probably, you know, will at least scrape the iceberg in a really bad way. There's something called the California King Tides Initiative. During the particular high tides, you can go out now and see streets being underwater. You have a seawall that's this high, the water laps up to, you know, just like right under the edge of the seawall. In Florida, there are backyards once a day underwater. What happens to coastal areas will happen to everyone. If we, you know, destroy through a hurricane or whatever the oil refining capacity of the United States, well, everyone in this country feels it and the prices go up. Business had a real wake-up call last year when there was enormous flooding in Thailand, and it affected a lot of the chip producers. So people in San Francisco and in Silicon Valley all of a sudden didn't have the supplies of chips that they're relying on. Then there's the question, okay, and where does your food come from? And where does your water come from? A lot of cities like, say, Phoenix or San Francisco don't get their water necessarily all from the local area. They get it from the mountains far away. There's been an enormous rise of interest at the local level in doing something about climate change. California is very often the policy leader in this country. It has never, ever started in Congress. Sometimes it literally comes down to one leader saying, I want this done in my community. Climate change is a real threat and a growing threat and a rapidly growing threat, but we have no choice but to deal with it.